We've been hearing this for weeks now, but it does appear, according to statements from the Iraqi army, that they feel increasingly confident they're getting to the very final stage of the final stage of kicking ISIS out of the old city of Mosul, the last population center of size they really control in Iraq. Now, it's been torturous going for Iraqi special forces, moving through that dense rabbit warren of alleyways that is the old city of Mosul, much of it reduced to rubble, their progress slowed by ISIS booby traps, snipers, nameless, numberless human shields being used there, civilians trapped in the midst of ISIS. We now understand from people on the ground that there possibly is about 150 to 200 meters left between those Iraqi special forces and the river that runs through Mosul that marks the back end of ISIS territory. So it is literally days, as we've heard before, but it does appear to be days now until that task is complete. A lot of political impatience in Baghdad for this to be over. We've heard repeated speeches from Iraqi Prime Minister Haider al-Abadi that the end is near. But it may well be soon that actually that is the truth, that in fact Mosul is pacified to some degree. Remember, there will always be a lower level insurgency of ISIS survivors enduring on. But it marks one more milestone for the slow demise of ISIS in the Middle East. I'm standing here in Syria, where we've just been, to Raqqa, to the old city there, into which a combination of Syrian, Kurdish and Arab fighters with a lot of American ground and air support have pushed past the over a thousand-year-old city walls into territory which, frankly, nobody thought they would be in quite so fast. The fight ahead is dense and urban and could take longer, but also, too, it comes at a time of changing geopolitical dynamics. We have just heard from the last meeting, the first meeting between Donald Trump and his counterpart in Russia, Vladimir Putin. For the first time, the White House and the Kremlin appear to meet and have much in common. They agreed on a de-escalation deal in southwestern Syria, hardly the biggest flashpoint in that war-torn, beleaguered country, but one where Syrian regime forces and Syrian rebels backed by the US have come occasionally into clashes. We don't know the details. It may calm things down, but more importantly, it has the White House and the Kremlin singing off the same script for the first time in a while. Remember, the Obama administration wanted Bashar al-Assad, the Syrian president, gone. Russia is its key backer. We don't know what this means going forward, but times are changing fast here. ISIS is in its final stages, and we're looking at a different geopolitical dynamic that may reshape these war-torn countries.